Hello there, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to Why Am I Dead Rebirth. Unless, of course, this is all the same video, in which case I'm just sounding like a moron. I have questioned everybody as, actually, I don't... What is my name? I keep telling people. Who are you? I'm Lucille. What is your name? Cricket. That's right. Oh, almost unintentionally a dick. Anyway, so I've been questioning everyone as Cricket. I think it's time to select someone else. Hello. So you're trying to find the murderer? Yeah, I guess I am. I mean, the police won't be here for a while and we're all trapped in the storm, so I figured it's up to us to find out who did this. What have you found out? Well, taking a look at the crime scene didn't yield any clues. However, I've narrowed down a list of suspects by figuring out everyone's alibis. What are they? Or how did you figure something like that out? This sounds suspicious, and I'm kind of thinking that she had something to do with the murder. She knows something about the murder. I don't think she actually did it, but I think she saw it. And she was, scared into keeping silent, which means she's probably gonna die. How did you find something like that out? How did I find that out? Oh, well, to be honest, I heard about it from Ted. It all seems to line up with the facts, and I have no reason to distrust him. Ted told you that. Interesting. It is? Never mind. Okay, so it's time to go question Ted, because Ted is apparently very shady. And he's trying to save the game. Not nice, Ted. I saved the game. Ted. So I hear you talking to Cricket about alibis. You did? You heard that? You told him about everyone's alibis. Dot. Yes, of course. I did tell him that. He seems very committed to finding out what happened to the owner. I also determined he couldn't have been the killer, so I tried to help him where I could. These two have something going on. Maybe. He seems almost scared of her, though, and she seems a little more aggressive now and not so... This is weird. How do you know so much about everyone? Well, I wouldn't say I know about everyone. It's really Orville. I feel kind of bad for the guy, so I tried to talk to him. He's got an awful habit of sticking his nose into other people's business. His nose, huh? And it's really gabby. I guess that's the case. It served a good purpose, though. So you only heard from Orville. Good to know. Yeah, like I said, he's kind of creepy, but I feel bad for him. Okay, forget it. Let's go talk to Orville. Let's go back to his room. Ah, there, creepy. What do you do for... Why am I asking this question? Well, young miss, I'm glad you asked. It's a thing prone to lots of judgment by small-minded people. But being an expeditionist is about getting past all that. All the judging. It's about getting down to the root, you know? The root. It's... I'm sorry I asked. You aren't who I'm looking for. People are so mean to him. But he kind of has it coming. I hear you've been talking to Ted. Ted? Sorry, doesn't ring any bells. Is a guy with a hide about black hair? Nope, not ringing any bells. Let me think. Alright, now I remember. I remember that I haven't seen anything like that. You are being suspicious. This guy hanging around the hotel lounge. Nope, don't think I've been there. Actually, to be honest, I'm not sure what a lounge is. You are an idiot. That's strange. You told me you two were best friends. No way. He really said that? Best friends? And by that, I mean, who's Ted? Sorry, it doesn't ring any bells. So you know Ted. You just said so. Stop wasting my time. Whoa, let's just calm down. Okay, so I've talked to Ted. A little bit. We're sort of buddies. Nothing else to say about it, really. It's not so important. You told him where people were on the night of the murder. No, I don't remember talking to him about that. We talked about all sorts of stuff, but not that. Weather, sports, chicks. Chicks? Yeah, chicks. You know, like, babes. We were talking about that because that's what guys talk about. Guys who have experience with chicks. Which is what we are. I'm about to lose my patience. That usually means people go to the hospital. Okay, I'm just joshing you. It was a joke. You're a very clever woman. So smart. No way I could fool you. Please don't hurt me. I told Ted a little bit about the other hotel tenants. Just a teeny little bit. Tiny little bit. Some of that may or may not have been about where they were the night of the murder. I will answer the third one after I get to the second one. Why'd you lie to me about not knowing Ted? I wasn't lying. I was just fibbing a little teensy bit. Ted told me that I talk too much about stuff and I should probably not mention to others what I tell him. There may or may not have been some vile, veiled threats involved. I can't remember. It's hard to say. Why'd you tell him? To be honest, not that I haven't been honest up to this point, or that I wasn't going to be honest in the first place. I mean, Ted kind of told me to do some research for him, keeping an eye out on the hotel residents and report back to him. You know, nothing weird. This Ted guy. I question him. So Ted asked you to spy on the others for him, and then he shared that information with Cricket. Very suspicious. Suspicious? Is that a good thing? It's a good kind of suspicious. No, it isn't. Okay. So it's obvious Ted's got something hidden. Well, now what? I guess I could question the other two that don't have alibis. As her, although I might get her killed. Is there something I can help you with? Did you know the owner? I'm not going to ask what you did, because I know what you did, and she's probably not going to tell me. I wouldn't say that I knew the man, but we had some brief encounters in the hotel. Nothing more. That is a burn on the hotel manager. It's a shame what happened to him, though. I see. Was that it? Did he have something else to add? No, that's all. She doesn't believe her. Okay. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Hi, girl. Randy. He's down here. What am I thinking? Down here in the tiny room over here with all the alcohol. Hello. Holy shit, she speaks. Are you finally able to hold a conversation, girl? You knew the owner? Oh yeah, of course I did. He was my boss. Did he mention he was going to meet someone from outside the hotel recently? Why would I ask that question? Unless Lucille knows something about that question. Someone from outside the hotel? What? How did you know about... da-da-da-da? What I mean is, mind your own damn business. I don't see what any of the owner or his personal affairs have to do with you. I'll take that as a yes. Take it however you want. Just leave me alone. Okay. So there's something going on there, too. I talked to Morgan. I'm confused. I need to talk to someone else. As someone else. I don't think I'm going to get any further. What about her? She seems kind of like a dick. Hey, the minister, what you doing? Nothing really. What about yourself? Just going around trying to bother people, really. That's funny, but I'm sure you're not bothering anyone. I hope I am. It's way more fun that way. You're not serious, are you? A game? Yeah, I try to find what makes people uncomfortable and talk about that. It's fun. Child after my own heart. Okay. So what are you doing as part of that game, right? Pretty much. Yeah, why? I don't know, mister. You just look like you're on the watch for something. Haha, no, not really. I think you're lying, mister. You're a good liar, but I can still tell. Okay, kid, what are you talking about? Well, people always seem to be gauging people around you like you're looking for someone you don't know who it is yet. Da-da-da-dot. Right, like you're picking someone. Am I right, mister? Am I right? Haha, go away. He's a murderer. I think he is. How about you? You're kind of aggressive, dude. Hey, mister. Hi there, how are you, little girl? Why did he stutter? You okay, mister? You look sad. Me? Oh yeah, I'm okay. Don't worry about me. Just, you look exactly like my daughter did. Oh. She must have looked a lot older by now, I guess. You haven't seen your daughter? No, not for 3 years now. Why not? Well, I did some bad things. Things I'm not proud of. And now I'm not allowed to see her. What if you apologize? Won't she forgive you? It's not like that. I can't get back into the country. I'd be arrested. I made some big mistakes in life and I ended up under the thumb of a complete scumbag. We had a deal, me and him. We had a deal. I could go back. I could see my daughter. But now he's dead. Oh. And that deal is history. The only proof it ever happened is just a pile of letters under my mattress. Investigate it. Looks like there's an envelope. However, you don't have any use for this. Someone else might be interested. I see. Get out of the way! Go! Go! Jeez! Oh. You are annoying. Yeah, as soon as I look at the flood that goes up here. Ooh, I didn't mean to go in the door. Okay, what do I need to do here? There's a pile of actual. I guess I should just go get Cricket. Not in here. There you are. Cricket can look under the mattress. Underneath is all of them are addressed by the owner of the hotel, Randy. While they talk about different things, they all mention some kind of deal between the two. There are also several veiled threats aimed at Randy. What would he have to say about this, I wonder? I found the letters in your room. How did you find these? The owner is blackmailing you, wasn't he? I guess, there's no point in lying about it. You've already seen those letters. Yeah, me and the owner had some screwed up arrangement. Excuse me, I worked at the hotel, did errands for him, and it felt like a house servant. In return, he promised I'd be able to see my daughter again. How would you be able to see your daughter? He was a mysterious man. This may be a rinky-dink hotel he was in charge of, but I could tell he had his fingers on a lot of somethings. With the right connections and enough money, there's nothing you can't do in the world. Removing one man's criminal history would be simple. What kind of errands? Moving things around, transporting people, that kind of stuff. Nothing illegal, but it seems like he still left me feeling uneasy. I was never told why I was doing these things, like he was hiding stuff from me. But I never cared to figure out what. Thanks for the information. Yeah, only because you twisted it out of me. Dot. Look, kid, if you really set on uncovering things around here, you should talk to Morgan. She got real close to the owner. Real close. If you know what I mean. Hint, hint. Wink, wink. I didn't call that one. She might know even more than I do. Uh-huh. Yeah, let's save. Save game. Is that this one? Nope. That's... Mean lady. Hey, actually, I'm curious. One thing. Little girl, come back. I'm a ghost haunting a little girl. That's a terrible thing of me. I'm a scummy person. I'm a genuinely scummy person. Nope, this one. What happens if I talk to her doll? Lagging? Randomly? Hello, Sarah. Hello, the doll talks! Mommy says we can leave the hotel as soon as the storm goes away. Of course, there's nothing in it for her to stay any longer. What do you mean? What do you think? She's here in the first place. If you leave, it's for vacation? She told me she wouldn't lie, right? Sarah's gone quiet. What do you think of the people here? They're all liars. Big lies, small lies, white lies, dark lies. But especially dark lies. What about the guy in the trench coat? Oh, except for him. He's just an idiot. Yeah, well, I called that one too. He sounds so serious. I am serious. The lies are moving toward each other. They will soon be in collision. Someone else will die. This I know. That's creepy. I think she's at Randy's daughter. If her daughter looks like his daughter, it makes sense that she could be. Oh, well. Beside the point, I'm going to confront her. Did you know the hotel owner? Randy says you and the hotel owner were seeing each other. Ha, and you believe what that oaf tells you? The man is constantly drunk. Anything he says is suspicious in my eyes. You're a fool to trust him. You yourself said that Randy knows about the owner. Well, he knew the owner was in a relationship with you. You have some nerve to call me a liar to my face, you know that? You're a green little boy that couldn't intimidate my daughter. Come back in 20 years when you've grown some backbone, maybe we can talk. What do I do then? She said backbone. She said she likes women that are really intimidating. This woman's pretty intimidating, and she's kind of a dick, so how about that? How are you doing, darling? I'm alright, my name's Morgan. How are you taking the owner's death? It's always unnerving for someone to die in such proximity to die in such a ghastly way. Although it's my daughter I'm worried about most, it's not something a child should see. Is that all? I was thinking you might feel more strongly given your relationship with the owner. I'm sorry? There was no relationship between me and the owner. Oh, it was very obvious. I only wonder if it was purely physical, if there was money involved. I don't even want to consider what you mean by that. Well, yeah, I'll be pretty direct. That's a vulgar accusation. I barely knew the man. I'm not the kind of woman, and I'm insulted you would suggest I am. I think you were chasing his money. If you were in a relationship with someone, it would not be for their money. You must be a bitter, cynical person for this to be your first assumption. Oh boy, I'm laying into her. Honey, listen to me and listen good. The whole thing is obvious. You aren't fooling me. All I want to know is, was he loaded? Dot. You are a vile and spiteful woman. Just like your mother, right? If you want to hear it so badly, then fine. I was sleeping with the owner, and yes, he was wealthy. In fact, grossly wealthy. At first, I considered myself lucky, but I soon realized something was wrong. There was no way he could have acquired the wealth through his hotel, and yet the money was pouring in. I stayed close to him in part to spy on him and his finances. My efforts led me to believe this hotel was nothing but a giant front. I hid away some of his paperwork in my dresser, and that points to this conclusion. If I had more time, I might have. Now that really interests me. I already knew he was a rotten thieving bastard. Seriously, I'm saying the hotel's a front for something illegal, and that doesn't bother you? You are truly a twisted person. She said she was hiding things in her drawer. My old lady. Investigate further. Yeah, that's not sketch. Underneath all the underwear is a giant brown envelope with the word confidential. Okay. Having to do with the personal finances. Why does she have these files? Let's talk to you. Found these files in your room. I can explain those. Oops, I didn't mean to skip that. I don't know how you found out about those files, but I guess it doesn't matter anymore. Yes, I've been trying to find out more about his business. They were very suspicious. Yeah, she's saying that just didn't match. I'm actually getting tired of reading, sorry. Oh no, what did I do? My bad. Yeah, actually, words. Well, it shouldn't, but mysteriously, money comes from nowhere to keep this place out of the red. It has led me to think this hotel is nothing but a front. What do you think is it a front for? It's not exactly what I was trying to figure out. I was hoping if I stuck around long enough, I could deduce that the owner was hiding. But with the owner gone, my supply of information It's possible there's the end of it, but what if he had partners? It's part of a larger ring. I'll never really know. You were in a relationship with the owner in order to get closer to those files, weren't you? That's really what you just said. I was in a relationship with him. I don't see how that was relevant, however, I chose to obtain those files on my own concern. Thank you for your help. Well, I suppose you can call it whatever you like. I'm sure you suspected that I was behind the owner's death or some nonsense. The bottom line is I had a good thing going with the owner. Perhaps I could have even ended up blackmailing him. Don't have any more time for you. Good luck with the rest of your investigation. Both of those two alibis checked out, so the only one who doesn't is Lucille. But I really don't think she killed him. I think she just saw who killed him. There are three people in this hotel with solid alibis. Without. You, Randy, and Morgan. I see. I'm sure you suspect me, but I didn't do it. It must have been somebody else. No, Randy was blackmailed by the owner. If he died, Randy wouldn't get to see his daughter, so he had a motive. And Morgan was in the middle of investigating his finances. His death only disrupted her search, so she didn't have it either. That leaves one person as a killer. That's you. D-d-d-d-d-d-dot. We need to talk, in complete privacy. Meet me in the owner's room. The scene of the crime. Okay. And, there are multiple endings. I don't know how to get those multiple endings, though. Okay, I need answers. Then you're in luck. Tell me what you need to know about this hotel. I don't know. It sounds like the owner may have been involved in something illegal. Morgan thought the hotel was a front. Wrong. The owner was a criminal, yes, but the hotel was not a front. It was a stage of the crime. Ooh. What do you mean? It suffices to say that the remote location of this hotel was by design, not accident. Away from society, away from the law. Make no mistake, this hotel deserves to be shut down and burned. And that was why you killed him? No, not exactly. He was not the only person whose investigation ended prematurely, or Morgan's. I had been careless and he discovered me in my search for evidence against him. In that moment, it was me or him. I chose myself. You have a gun, and a badge, and a license to kill to go along with it. Ooh. You're a cop. You were sent here to investigate the hotel. No, I came here on a trail of a known serial killer. One that I'm reasonably confident is here, in fact, here. That's Ted. Ted is the serial killer. However, when I grew suspicious of the owner, I realized he was more deserving of my attention. I'm not sure how to react. Act as if nothing has changed. My cover's blown, all of my work could be reversed. I think it's too late for that. Oh. I'm his partner. What are you doing? Why didn't I call that? I'm usually pretty good at calling those twists. You think that I was investigating the murder out of the goodness of my heart? How dumb. I was just trying to find the person who killed my business partner. You were the one who was planning to meet me. Blah, 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 blah. Goodbye. The end. Well, this has been Why Am I Dead? Rebirth, the remaking of this game. I will actually go make a walkthrough of this. I'm going to go do that right now. Go find all the endings and then, ooh, the sequel on Greenlight. I'm going to go check that out. I encourage you guys to go check it out. There's a sequel on Greenlight. I don't know what it's called. Yeah, I'll have a link down to this game below. If you guys want to play it, get the multiple endings yourself, investigate further. I know there are so many questions and combinations I didn't try that might be interesting that don't even lead to an ending, or maybe there's more endings than even I know of. But according to the developer, there are four endings here. I'm going to find those four endings, and I will make a walkthrough video after this that will show you how to get all four endings. So with that, I'm going to stop. You all have a great day, and I, Mr. BlubberButter, actually, if you wouldn't mind liking and subscribing, that'd be awesome too. I keep forgetting to mention that in my videos. Anyway, you all have a great day, and I, Mr. BlubberButter, we'll see you later.